Hi, this is Siddiq from Toronto, Ontario. So today we'll be discussing about the spousal points. Let's say if I'm married, then how my spouse can help me to get better score in CRS table or the Express Entity Profile as a whole. So before that, I want to recap you one more thing. Definitely you know or you may not know. To be qualified for the Express Entry Profile, you need to satisfy both the grades. I mean 100 grades and the 1200 grades. So let's start with the 100 grade first. So out of the 100 point grade, your spouse can contribute maximum 10 points. And how? I'll show you the table here. So in that 100 point grade, most of the point comes from your eligibility for sure, but there is something called adaptability. So in that adaptability criteria, you can claim maximum 10 points. And in these 10 points, there are a couple points which you can claim from your spouse if she or he has that potentiality. So number one, if he or she has set for the IELTS exam or the TEF and that is at least CLB 4 and above, that will give you 5 points. Then if your spouse have studied in Canada at least for 2 academic years, that will give you another 5 points. Then if he or she has 1 year of full-time experience in Canada, then that will give you another 5 points. Then if he or she has relatives in Canada, that must be of first blood, let's say parent, child, sibling, aunt, uncle, nephew, niece, that will get you another 5 points. So I'm telling you there are 4 criteria that can give you 5 each, but as I already mentioned, maximum point would be 10. That means even if your spouse satisfy all these 4, you cannot claim 20. That will give you any 10. So you can pick any 2 and go for it. But so far my understanding says some of you may have the relative criteria fulfilled, but other 3, maybe most likely most of us are not going to get qualified on those 3. Anyway, I just try to show you how can you claim some points if your spouse is eligible. Now I'm going to the 1200 grade where and how you can claim some points from your spouse. Now, out of that 1200 grade, your spouse can contribute maximum 40 points. And there is another 3 classifications of how these 40 points are coming. So number one is the education qualification. So I'm sharing the table with you and you can find which is your spouse's education level, and according to that you can claim maximum 10 points out of his or her education qualification. And again, I just mentioned here already in the table that has to be ECA done. That means if it is not done with ECA, then you cannot claim even a single point. So if he is bachelor, master's, whatever it is, that has to be evaluated by any of the ECA authorities. Then next classification would be the IELTS. Okay, so if he or she is achieving CLB level 4 or less, then in the CRS grade is 0, though in the 67 grade it was 5, but in CRS grade is 0. So for 5 and 6 it's 1, 7 or 8 it's 3, then CLB level 9 or more it's 5. Now though you can see the heading in the table, it said already the point per module. Please be noted that point per module means if there are 4 modules, so if your spouse is getting, let's say, 5 or 6, that means out of 20 you are getting just 4. This is how if somebody is scoring CLB level 9 or more, out of 20 you are getting 20, right? So then we are left with the last 10 points out of 40, which is Canadian experience. If you're lucky enough, you're fortunate enough, if your spouse have some Canadian experience, please mark this point, has to be Canadian experience, not back home experience. So if he or she has Canadian experience at least 1 year, then out of 10 is 5, then 2, 7, 3, 8 points, 4 years, 9 points, 5 or more would be 10 points. So this is how out of total 1200 points, your spouse can give you maximum 40 points. Now you know better how many potentials you have considering your spouse's this criteria. Then accordingly you can prepare your profile, you can request your spouse to help you let's say, sit for IELTS exam, get the ECA done, then for sure, if Canadian experience something, if she or he does already didn't been into the Canada, then for sure just forget it. But for the IELTS and ECA evaluation, definitely he or she can help you, right? And last but not the least, I would say, apart from these 40 points, okay, keep in mind the whole immigration journey is a quite long journey. So this is not about these points only. Definitely he or she must support you mentally, and definitely he or she must support you from every corners. Let's say I have seen so many couples, let's say the main applicant is the husband. So husband is busy with his office or his business. So in the meantime, the wife, though she is not able to contribute so many points, but at least she is Googling, she is roaming around in the YouTubes or Facebook groups. Then she is collecting some information and passing it to husband. So that is saving some time for the husband, and he is capable of getting accurate and more information. That is helping him to prepare the profile more efficiently. So this is how, like, spousal support is not by the points only. It has to be from every corner. So I guess this little video helped you to understand how your spouse can help you in this express entry journey. So if you like this video, please subscribe our channel and keep watching our next videos. See you on some other next episodes. Bye bye.